That is a crap load of formulas you have no interest in. I could see your face right now. You're like, why the hell am I learning this? But the point is, as much as I want you to learn it, I know you're not gonna learn it. That's why I made you a damn calculator, so you could just calculate it based on the values that they give you. Before we get started, make sure to go over to the subscribe button, smash that subscribe button, and hit the notification bell to get any new updates from us. I promise you it'll be a lot of value. You'll learn a lot, you'll get a lot of tips and tricks that you can share with your friends to make you seem all the more smarter. Alright guys, welcome back to another video of our How Money Works series. Today we are going to be playing with my compound interest with contributions calculator that I made myself, so you can't find this anywhere else. So we are going to play with our compound interest with contributions. I've shown how to use this simple compound interest calculator, this part, because there's really three different calculators in this one spreadsheet here. We already went through the first part in a different video. I'll link to that one, but we're gonna talk about these examples where if an amount of $5,000 is deposited into a savings account at an annual interest rate of 5%, that does not freaking exist in reality because this is just an example, at 5% compounded monthly with additional deposits, so you're depositing $100 extra every single month made at the end of each month, the value of the investments after 10 years can be calculated as follows. So you're really adding $100 at the end of the month. So say like you're in month, it's April right now. If I added my $100 at the end of April, then it will miss the entire month of April, the entire interest earning from April, but it will get the interest earning from the next month, which is May. So that's what it means by adding the additional deposits at the end of the month. And this is the formula for that. And to give you, this is more complicated than simple compound interest because you're doing contributions. When you add contributions, that makes things like stupid. So what is the same is what we're using is we're using PMT. What PMT is the monthly payment. In our example, that's $100. And then we times that by this formula, which is 1 plus R divided by N, R being the annual interest rate, N being the number of times that interest is compounded per unit T. T is pretty much the time, usually it's years, but it can be months or something like that, that the money is invested or borrowed for. And it's 1 plus R divided by T to the power of NT minus 1 divided by R divided by N. That is a crap load of formulas you have no interest in. I could see your face right now. You're like, why the hell am I learning this? But the point is, as much as I want you to learn it, I know you're not gonna learn it. That's why I made you a damn calculator, so you could just calculate it based on the values that they give you. Any bank will give you this like rate. All you need is the rate. Usually it's compounded by 12 because everything's compounded monthly. And time is basically how long you're leaving out that loan for, which is pretty much usually always in years. So that's why we have 10 years for T, compounded monthly, 12 for N, R is 5%. That's the rate that that we're loaning at. We're adding in $100 per month. So the future value of this series is $15,528.23. And to notice that this value was just for the future value of contributing $100 every single month at 5% interest rate, compounded monthly, 12, but for 10 years. So you still have to add on that compound interest for your initial payment, which was 5,000. So that's what we have here, because it's exact same values, and that gives us $8,235. So you add your $8,235 to your future value, $15,528.23, and you get $23,763.28. Not a bad amount of money. So what if you changed it? What if we're adding the $100 at the start of the month? So in my month of April right now, instead of adding it at the end, I'm adding it at the beginning of April. So it earns that entire interest of April. Well, to do that, all we have to do is just take that same formula that we just did and times it by 1 plus R divided by N, and you'll have your answer. So this is the same exact numbers that you plug in, except that the difference will be $15,592.93, just because we times it by that 1 plus R divided by N in red here. And again, you're just going to add up our principal, or our compound interest for our principal, which is $8,235.05, plus the future value of our series with our deposits made at the start of the month, at the beginning of the month. Why does it say end here? That's not right. At the start of the month. So $15,592.93. Total you'll get is $23,827.98. So the difference between that is just chump change. If you really want to change it, so we'll just do that here. Take that minus that amount, $64.70. That's the difference that you get. So just to tell you the truth, these formulas, they weren't from me. I just Googled them and found this article from this site, and I looked through their formula and did the calculations. They worked. So I took that formula from the calculator site and then I put it in a spreadsheet and made my own calculator. But I made my calculator using their formula. This is not their calculator, it's my calculator. And I could give you this calculator if you're gonna join our newsletter, and you could put it to your own use to calculate the what your interest will be. And we're gonna come back to this to learn about the rule of 72 and the interest rate needed. But other than that, that's all I wanted to go through with you. Compound interest with contributions. Hope you're gonna make use of that. But other than that, please join our newsletter for tips and tricks from myself and my advisor, who is an ex-CFO of mid-sized firm and an ex-financial auditor of KPMG, which is one of the big four accounting firms in the world. And please rate, comment, subscribe, and let us know in the comments whether you're liking these kind of videos, and let us know what you want to learn. And we'll see you guys again in the next video. Take care.